Well, let's take a little look, before we go any further, at a clip from the last interview we did, which is February 2011.
Okay.
And I think will be politely described as the height of Sheen mania.
I mean, addiction specialists, you've seen them all coming out in the last few
years. Been around them for 22 years.
Right.
And they've been lying to me for two decades.
Right. Well, and we'll come to that. But the premise of their argument with you is that you're in some kind of denial about this. And actually, you've never really stopped and thought, I've got to sort myself out properly. That if you do follow their programs, they can work. And lots of people would be watching this saying, it worked for me.
And then I can have a life like theirs? I'm going to pass.
Really? So why?
Why? Because I'm a winner, and their lives look like they're, you know, ruled by losers. I mean, just to put it in black and white terms, I don't want their lives, and they want mine, but they want to criticize the hell out of it, you know? And now they've run the gamut from, like, okay, he's not loaded, now what? Oh, he's manic. I don't even know what that means. That, I guess, would imply that there's going to be a crash. I don't know when that's coming, but maybe you can cover it when it does.
Two fascinating things. One, what you were saying there. Two, your reaction to what you were saying
there.
How
about let you finish the question? Man.
Don't worry, I interrupt all the time, too.
Wow.
But what do you feel about what you just watched there of yourself?
It's a little cringeable. It's a little bit cringeable. It's a little bit hard to watch. I mean, I thought I looked okay. But no, it's a guy who's involved in something otherworldly at the time.
It was like you were at war with everybody.
Yes. Yeah.
Literally at war with everyone.
Yeah, whether they were picking a fight or not.